Hi all, in this video lecture we will be discussing about the basics of amplitude modulation and we will derive an expression for AM modulated wave.
Amplitude modulation. In amplitude modulation, the amplitude of the carrier signal is varied in accordance with the instantaneous value of message signal, keeping the carrier frequency and phase constant. That is, here the carrier signal amplitude is changed in accordance with the instantaneous value of amplitude of message signal. That is, we call it as an amplitude modulation. We move on to its waveform. Here, the first represents the carrier waveform, which is of high frequency nature, carrier form, which is represented by small vc, and its amplitude is capital Vc. And the second represents the modulating signal or message signal, represented by small vm, and its amplitude is capital Vm. And this is the amplitude modulated waveform, represented by Vam. This is the amplitude modulated waveform. In this Vc represents the baseline, which corresponds to the maximum value of carrier waveform Vc. That is this line Vc. Maximum value of carrier waveform. From there, we will draw similar waveform to that of modulating waveform. With this base Vc, we will draw similar waveform to that of the modulating signal Vm, such that the amplitude of the AM wave will be this Vc plus small Vm, modulating signals Vm, and the maximum amplitude of carrier frequency Vc. The maximum amplitude of the AM waveform will be Vc plus small Vm. This Vc corresponds to maximum frequency of carrier waveform, and the small Vm is the instantaneous value of our modulating signal. Similarly, this Vc minus Vm, this value, this line represents the E minimum value, and this Vc plus Vm represents the E maximum value. This is all about the waveform. Here, the carrier amplitude is changed in accordance with the amplitude of message signal. So we move on to the expression for deriving the AM modulated waveform. First, the instantaneous value of modulating signal, that is also called as message signal, is given by small Vm equal to capital Vm sine omega mt, which represents the modulating signal. So the suffix is given by a modulating signal. This is represented by small Vm, and this capital Vm is the amplitude of the modulating signal. Next, the instantaneous value of carrier signal, that is high frequency signal, represented by small Vc equal to capital Vc sine omega ct, which represents the instantaneous value of carrier, that is Vc, and this represents the instantaneous value of our message signal Vm. Here you should note that capital Vm is the amplitude of modulating signal, and the capital Vc represents the amplitude of the carrier signal. The amplitude of the modulated waveform is represented by capital A, amplitude of modulated waveform, that is our AM waveform. Its amplitude is represented by capital A, which is equal to Vc plus small Vm, where Vc is the amplitude of carrier signal and Vm represents the modulating signal. So the AM modulated signal will have an maximum amplitude of V capital Vc plus small Vm. That is given here, the amplitude of modulated wave, AM modulated wave, capital A equals capital VC plus small vm, which is equal to VC is the amplitude of the carrier signal and vm is the instantaneous value of modulating signal. We substitute the value of vm. Vm, we already know that vm, small vm equals capital Vm sin omega mt. We substitute the value of small vm here. Small vm equal to capital Vm sin omega mt. Then we will take the capital Vc outside. Common, we will take the common Vc. So which is equal to Vc whole into 1 plus Vm by Vc sin omega mt. In this this factor, Vm by Vc is called as the modulation index. Maximum value of modulating signal to maximum value of carrier signal, which is given by modulation index. It is denoted by small m, and we substitute the value of Vm by Vc as small m. Thus, we get A equals amplitude of modulated signal equals Vc into 1 plus m into sin omega mt, which is denoted by the equation 1. Then we ask the frequency of carrier wave is unaltered. The instantaneous voltage of the resulting amplitude modulated waveform is given by, that is the expression for modulated waveform, amplitude modulated waveform is given by A sin omega ct. Since the carrier frequency is unaltered in amplitude modulation, therefore Vam is given by A into sin omega ct. Then we have already find out the amplitude of Am modulated wave. We have already find out the amplitude of Am modulated wave as this expression by equation 1. We will substitute the value of A in this equation. So Vam, amplitude modulated waveform, is given by we will substitute the value of A, which is Vc into 1 plus m sin omega mt into sin omega ct. In this equation, we substitute the value of A. Then we will multiply. We will open the bracket and multiply. Thus, we get Vam equals Vc sin omega ct plus Vc m into sin omega ct into sin omega mt, which is taken as equation 3. This sin omega t into sin omega mt, we can use this trigonometric identity sin A sin B here. Sin omega ct into sin omega mt, we can apply the trigonometric identity sin A sin B, which is equal to half into cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. We will apply that trigonometric identity here, and the equation 3 becomes Vam equals Vc sin omega ct plus Vc into m. This sin omega ct into sin omega mt becomes half into cos of omega c minus omega m into t minus cos of omega c plus omega m whole into t. We will open the bracket. Then the amplitude modulated waveform, we will get it as Vc sin omega mt, and this consists of mainly three terms. When we open, we can see that the amplitude modulated waveform consists of three terms represented by A, B and C, where A is the A is Vc sin omega ct, which represents the original carrier signal. That the carrier signal that we have used in modulation, that is Vc sin omega ct. This first term represents the, now we can show that the first term is same as that Vc, instantaneous value of carrier signal, Vc sin omega ct. This is the first term, Vc sin omega ct. First term
VC sin omega CT, which represents the original carrier signal voltage. The second term MVC by 2 cos omega C minus omega M into T, which represents the lower sideband LSB of the amplitude with the amplitude MVC by 2 and frequency FC minus FSM. This represents the lower sideband omega C minus omega M, and MVC by 2 is the amplitude. And the third term C is represented by the sum term, and B is the frequency difference term, and this is the sum term, which represents the upper sideband USB of the signal with the amplitude MVC by 2 and frequency FC plus FM. That's the AM modulated waveform consists of three parts. First, the original carrier signal, and one lower sideband and one upper sideband. Then we will draw a frequency spectrum of the AM modulated waveform. That the first term, A term, contains frequency FC and its magnitude is VC. The first term, A term. The A term consists of amplitude VC and frequency FC. That is represented here. That is represented here. FC with the amplitude VC, and lower sideband and upper sideband having the magnitude MVC by 2, and the lower sideband has a frequency of FC minus FM, and here the upper sideband has a frequency of FC plus FM. From the spectrum we can see that the it consists of three frequencies. One central frequency, which is that of carrier signal, and one lower sideband frequency and one upper sideband frequency. Then we can derive the expression for the bandwidth. Bandwidth is given by upper sideband minus lower sideband. Upper sideband is FC plus FM minus lower sideband is FC minus FM. And when we simplify it, we will get it as 2FM, which is the bandwidth of a AM modulated waveform, and its modulation index we already seen in the derivation that M is given by Vm by Vc, that is the amplitude of modulated signal to amplitude of carrier signal, which lies between the value of 0, and modulation index value lies between 0 and 1 in case of AM modulated wave. It is the ratio of modulating voltage to carrier voltage. As this can be expressed as percentage, it is called as depth of modulation. So in this video we have seen the operation of the working of amplitude modulation. This waveform is very important. Carrier signal, high frequency signal, its magnitude is VC. This is the modulating signal or our message signal, low frequency signal. Its amplitude is capital Vm, and this is the AM modulated wave. When we draw this, consider this VC, capital VC, as the baseline, and with the reference we have to draw Vm, that is the modulating signal. That is, in AM the carrier amplitude is changed in accordance with the amplitude of the message signal, and in this derivation this represents the incidence value of modulating signal, and this represents the incidence value of carrier signal. A is denoted by the amplitude of the modulated waveform, which is the sum of VC plus VM. In the figure it is clear that its maximum amplitude is VC. VC is the carrier capital VC plus VM, the modulating signal, capital A. We first find the expression of capital A, then we substitute the value of A in the modulated waveform equation, then we simplify it, and we use this identity, and we get the three terms in the modulated waveform.
And finally, we draw the frequency spectrum and derive the bandwidth of the AM modulated waveform. Thank you.